The year 2001 was a simpler time. I was living with my parents. Gas cost $1.26 a gallon, and no blonde woman had ever gone to law school before. Or at least it seemed that way in this week's new Netflix gem.
This is the type of girl that Warner wants to marry. This is what I need to become to be serious. A law student.
I'm Clint Gage, and you're watching Stream on Movie Phone. That's right, guys, Legally Blonde, the surprisingly hilarious 2001 movie, is now on Netflix. I like this movie because it appears to be stupid, but is actually full of smart jokes about stupid things, which is an important distinction for a smart and stupid man like myself. Plus, this was the movie that really made Reese Witherspoon famous at the devastatingly old age of 25.
I'm sorry, are you here to see me?
I go here.
You got into Harvard Law?
What, like it's hard?
If you power through that one and want more, you can watch the sequel, Legally Blonde 2, Red, White, and Blonde, also on Netflix. It's not as good as the first one, but nothing ever is. Also now on Netflix is The Last Waltz, the epic concert documentary of a great little band called The Band.
The road has taken a lot of the great ones. Hank Williams, Buddy Holly, Otis Redding, Janis, Jimi Hendrix, Elvis. It's a damn impossible way of life.
Martin Scorsese basically took the band's 1976 farewell concert and blew it up into a movie. And if you like rock and roll or any music at all, you will enjoy this. Finally, the 1994 movie The Professional is now on Amazon. A hitman takes a young girl under his wing after her family is killed.
What exactly do you do for a living?
Cleaner.
You mean you're a hitman? Cool.
This is a very cool movie. Great action scenes, disturbing plot, and get this, that little girl is a preteen Natalie Portman, and this was her first feature film. Turns out, she was a great actress even before we knew she was going to be super hot. Who knew, right? That's all for now. We'll see you next week.